And in essence, the unlegislated means they commonly are a result of seeking assistance from other than Allah. We're seeking human intervention. We're trying to draw the attention of the humans before we return back to Allah Azza wa Jalla. وهذه المشكلة. The Nasr, victory is from Allah.
وَمَا النَّصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ.
So if you want victory, يعني, this is no better way than seeking it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Somebody will tell you you're very passive. You're passive and you're just, you know, all you want to do is just sit there and read your book. Wallahi, if they were legislated and they were founded upon Quran and Sunnah, we would hope, I'm not going to praise ourselves and say we'll be the first one in the row, like you find some other people say, we'll be the first one. Allah knows where we would be. But we'd say that if they were legislated, we would hope for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to place in us that tawfiq to be from among those who take part. And the points that we're going to mention, you will find the political activists and those who have their own perceptions when it comes to how we should create change. You will find that they will say you're dumbing down the affair, you're numbing the affair, you are not putting it out as it should be, we need to do more. Wallahi, doing more is found in following the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let's agree to that. Doing more is found in the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Beyond that, are we actually doing more or are we creating harm? Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentions in Al-Furusiyya Al-Muhammadiyya a number of points that we should note. These are keys to success, keys to victory. He says towards the end of the book, وَنَخْتِمُ هَذَا الْكِتَابِ بِآيَةٍ مِنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. And we will conclude this book with an ayah from the book of Allah. جَمَعَ فِيهَا تَدْبِيرَ الْحُرُوفِ بِأَحْسَنِ تَدْبِيرٍ. And Allah Azza wa Jalla has structured the letters in the most beautiful way in this ayah. وهي قوله تعالى, which is a statement of Allah the Most High.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا لقيتم فئة فاثبتوا واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون وأطيعوا الله ورسوله ولا تنازعوا فتفشلوا وتذهب ريحكم واصبروا إن الله مع الصابرين.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا, or you who believe, إذا لقيتم فئة, if you meet a group from the enemy, فثبتوا, remain firm, واذكروا الله كثيرا, and remember Allah much, لعلكم تفلحون, so you will be successful. وأطيعوا الله ورسوله, and obey Allah and His Messenger. ولا تنازعوا, and do not dispute, فتفشلوا, and then be defeated, become weak. وتذهب ريحكم, and become winded. واصبروا إن الله مع الصابرين, and be patient, Allah is with those who are patient. So he says Ibn Qayyim, he's talking about the ways to victory. He is doing a time where the jihad is occurring. How did he address the issue? By these points. And it's simple. Sometimes he's saying, people are saying, it's too simple. This can't be the way. I need something more. It's just like you find when you're dealing with someone who is involved in the tasawwuf and Sufism, you just tell him, the way to the Jannah, simple, follow Quran and Sunnah, follow the guidance. He said, but this is too simple. We need more. We need that spirituality. We need the spirituality. What's the spirituality you're talking about? That we sit together and we do dhikr. This is spirituality? If this was correct, why didn't the Prophet ﷺ do it? Why didn't his companions do it? Why didn't any of the Salaf do it? If this is not being satisfied with what the Quran and the Sunnah has brought. We want more. But he's in a time where jihad is happening. He tells us that this ayah has told us. فَأَمَرَ الْمُجَاهِدِينَ فِيهَا بِخَمْسَةِ أَشْيَاءِ. He, Allah, ordered the mujahideen with five things. مَجْتَمَعَتْ فِي فِئَةٍ قَطْ. That has never united in a people. إِلَّا نُصِرَتْ. Except they were granted victory. وَإِنْ قَلَّتْ وَكَثُرَ عَدُوهَا. Even if they're few in number and the enemy is vast in number. Five points which are found in these ayat. Take them down. ثبات, being firm upon our religion. This is one. الثاني, كَثَرَةُ ذِكْرِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Remembering Allah much. This is a way to victory. الثالث, طَاعَتُهُ وَطَاعَةُ رَسُولِهِ. Obeying Allah and obeying His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. الرابع, اتِّفَاقُ الْكَلِمَةِ. Being united in our statement. وَعَدَمُ التَّنَازُعُ الَّذِي يُوجِبُ الْفَشَلُ وَالْوَهْنِ. And not disputing, which necessitates being defeated and weakness. Through this, the disputing, what happens is, those who are disputing will strengthen their enemy and give them a hand over them. فَإِنَّهُ فِي اجْتِمَاعِهِمْ كَالْحُزْنَ مِنَ السِّهَامِ لَا يَسْتِطِي أَحَدْ كَسْرَهَا. Because when the Muslims unite, they are like a stack of arrows. If somebody had a stack of arrows, it's difficult to break them. فإذا فرقها but if he was to divide those arrows صار كل منهم وحدة every one of them becomes individual and he breaks them all of them. الخامس the fifth of them is ملاك ذلك كله وقوامه وأساسه that which unites all of this and is the foundation and the basis for all of this وهو الصبر being patient حبس اللسان restraining your tongue حبس الأعضاء restraining your limbs حبس النفس restraining your soul you see things and you're burning inside and you want to do something but you say I'm not going to do what opposes the sharia of Allah the sabr is needed فهذه خمسة أشياء تبتنى عليها قبة النصر these are five things that the dome of victory is built upon ومتى زالت أو بعضها and when they vanish or some of them زال من النصر بحسب ما نقص منها that victory will also lessen in proportion to whatever is missing from these elements.